this is Enterprise News Headlines. I am Angela Ackman. Following the liquidation of the Skye Bank Plc, the governor of the Central Bank of Nigeria, Godwin Emefiele, said that the decision was due to the failure of its shareholders to recapitalize the bank. The chief relationship officer of Foresight Securities, Mr. Charles Fakraogh, in an interview with Enterprise Television, stated that the Nigerian Stock Exchange regulators' operators had tried all they could to ensure that the investors' confidence is restored back to the market before Skye Bank's incident.
Management of any quoted company should focus mainly on corporate governance. The issue of not managing a lending institution is a problem, and the regulators should begin to sanction individual managers who are involved in mismanaging some of these lending institutions.
Also speaking, Mr. Chuks Orakama, Lighthouse Asset Management Limited, described the liquidation of the Skye Bank as unfortunate, and the action will affect the investment community.
It's quite unfortunate, and it will have a very far-reaching negative effect on the investing community.
Nigeria government has approved the payment of 42.68 billion naira for the payment of retirement benefit to ex-workers of the liquidated Nigeria Airways Limited and the revitalization of public universities in the country. The Minister of Finance, Mrs. Zainab Ahmed, disclosed that the 20 billion naira was released to the education sector as part of the government's promise to revitalize the public universities and ensure the smooth running of the tertiary education system in the country. The approval for the release of the amount was given by President Muhammadu Buhari. According to the minister, the release of the funds was part of the implementation of a bilateral agreement signed in 2013 by the Nigerian government and the Academic Staff Union of Universities. She added that the government would monitor the progress of the implementation of the disbursement with a view to resolving emerging issues and keeping its promises to relevant stakeholders. And in Africa, Ghana's central bank governor Ernest Edison said Ghana kept its benchmark interest rate unchanged at 17% on Monday, as expected, mindful of possible inflationary headwinds as the dollar strengthened. According to him, this would also help to cushion any spillover effect from fuel price increase and a potential trade war between the United States and China. He said the most recent forecast showed rate of disinflation slowing marginally on possible second-round effect of recent increase in petroleum prices, exchange rate depression, and tax increases. Ghana is a major commodity exporter, but its city currency has been unstable since May, touching new lows this month as investors pulled away from emerging market assets. Still on the African continent, Egypt's central bank is expected to leave interest rates on hold at its policy meeting on Thursday as emerging market turbulence weighs on the economy even as inflation shows signs of slowing. The country's economies confirmed that the bank's monetary policy committee was likely to maintain its deposit and lending rates at 16.75% and 17.75%. Economists said that despite the improving inflation figures, investors have grown wary of Egypt and other emerging markets since currency crisis hit Turkey and Argentina in August. The central bank's monetary policy committee raised rates by 700 points over the course of 8 months after its November 2016 agreement with the IMF to dampen inflation. And on the foreign scene, Comcast has confirmed it had bought 29.1% of the Sky Group shares in the market. Comcast bid £17.28 a share for Sky, beating a £15.67 offer from Rupert Murdoch's 24th Century Fox. However, Fox owned a 39% stake in Sky, which is selling to Walt Disney as part of a separate deal. Comcast said it was seeking to make further market purchases of Sky shares at a price of £17.28 per share. Moving down to sports, Real Madrid once more weighed heavily in the peak of football stars for 2018, contributing four current players as well as the new Juventus signing. Cristiano Ronaldo and Lionel Messi have both been named in the FIFA Pro World 11, but Mohamed Salah and Neymar did not make the cut. World Cup winners Kylian Mbappe, Rafael Varane and N'Golo Kante were included, with Manchester United star Paul Pogba missing out. Kante's Chelsea teammate Eden Hazard futures in a four-man forward line, with David De Gea, the only Premier League star, included. And that's it on Enterprise's headlines for today. For more news, updates, special reports and our shows, you can visit our website www.enterprisetv.tv. Our social media platforms are always there for your all-round information in the world of business. I am Angela Akman. Many thanks for watching.